we've already shared what we've already talked to you privately, informed you, which you already know that we can't do nothing without your power, without your strength. God, actually speak to these clay lips of ours. Give us a word today. Help us understand that we're so valuable to you. And God, just bless us collectively as a Christian body of Jesus Christ. We thank you for everything today. Now, speak to our hearts in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. From the scripture verse, I'm going to talk on the thought today entitled, "There's a brave hero inside of you." There's a brave hero inside of you. My brothers and my sisters, Daniel in our text, he shows all of God's children. He shows us a valuable lesson that true obedience to God is obeyed when no one or nobody is looking at you. And we'll find out more detail. But Daniel, he shows us that obedience, true obedience, is obedience when no one is looking at you. The truth of the matter, we must understand, God is always looking at us. He sees us when we think nobody else sees. We must keep that in our mind, that God is always not only looking, he's listening to us. We must realize that our character is revealed by what we do in the very dark as well as the light. It reflects who we are. Anybody can put a show on. But are we who we are when can't nobody else see, right? Now, if you look at Daniel, he's a friend of ours. He's our cousin today. Daniel had some problems just like you and I. But one thing he did not do, he did not let his problems determine his future. Daniel could have left personal trauma of his past. You know how it is, we constantly go back to how we was treated in our past. And sometimes that's what we talk about, and we try to use that as an excuse.
Yes.
But Daniel, he did not let his past trauma affect his whole life. Because when you get a chance, read. I know you already know, but read about Daniel. Because at a young teen, he was brought into captivity. Talking about a young boy here, he was brought into captivity, but we have to understand God had smiled on Daniel.
Come on.
Yeah, Daniel, God gave Daniel a intellectual and gave him spirituality. So he was a smart, just like our children today, you know, making these A's and B's and honor rolls and going to college and graduating and doing some outstanding thing to our community as well as our church at large and our family. Daniel was a very intelligent and very spiritual person even when he was young. At his youth, Daniel was separated from the rest of the Jews. Let me say that one more time. At his youth, Daniel was separated from the rest of the Jews. We have people here today, young people here today, that God have separated you. Amen. From the rest of your friends. God did. Matter of fact, before you was born, God had already selected you. And that's why you can't fit in. That's why you can't blend in. That's why, really, if I go back to my young life, I remember that I tried to go to a party one time. I tried to go out there and jam. I tried to go back, you know, to my early jamming stage. And I was out there trying to jam, and a friend of mine, he came up to me, he said, "Man, look here, let me tell you something. You messing up the party. This ain't you." I had my stuff together, I was moving and grooving. I thought I was doing it. You know, I spent around a couple times. You know, brother messed up my party. I had to leave. Look like a fool or idiot out there. But anyway, the spirituality. capability God gave Daniel is God taught him, or should I say, he got it because of his closeness to God in prayer. Daniel, he was a praying young man. He prayed. He talked to the Lord, just like Minister Taylor shared with us today, telling our young people how they ought to pray to God. You know, so Daniel was taught by, amen, his parents how to pray. That's what we need to do. We need to cut the TV off and stop looking at all the programs and get with our children and let's teach them how to pray. You know, how do we teach them by an example? We ought to see us praying. You know, sometimes they'll see us praying. You know, I know coffee's good and food is good and all that good stuff, but before we eat, they ought to see us praying. They ought to hear us singing sometimes. They ought to see joy in us. So Daniel was taught. He was taught how to pray. Not only just pray, but he was taught how to listen to God. So he prayed to God, then he waited for moments where God would talk back to him. How many of us, as Christians, we pray to God, but we don't wait to God to talk to us. We tell people, I prayed about it. Yes, I prayed about it, but we didn't wait long enough for God to talk to us. So Daniel, he prayed. Him and God had a great relationship. That he prayed to God, and God taught him. God said, look here, you've been selected by me. And God told him, y'all know the story, we talked about this before. God, he prayed to God, and God told him, you can't eat certain things. Yeah. You can't eat certain types of food. We would be in better condition today. Our health would be better. I'm talking to myself, you know, I had to have an ice cream and a sweet, maybe a piece of peppermint, but I had really dug down like I used to dig, you know, the whole week. Now, I want some of that. I want some sweets, but my body wants some sweets, but I'm trying to get my mind. I'm trying to get my mind able to control my body. Anybody get that? You know, a whole lot of us, you know, I'm going to put some vinegar on it. I'm going to eat me just a little bit. The doctor told you don't need any sweets. You don't need to eat certain food, but look at us. I'm going to vinegar down. We're going to put some vinegar on it, then I'm going to pray about it, then we'll eat some. You go ahead. You grown. Your head hurting. You try to stand up, you get dizzy. Don't come here, come out. Come right over and y'all pray for me. I'm about to fall off. Shanae, but you should, if God told you not to do it, you shouldn't have did it. I believe this. And I want to get to the point. I got a friend, every time he turn around, he's boasting, bragging about, you know, trying to get mad, but trying not to get mad. He's bragging about, man, I'm lean, I'm down to this, and I'm lean, and you know, I'm trying, I know I'm in the flesh, and I don't want to get upset, but, you know, because I know I got weight problems. Y'all pray for me. And I'm trying to lose some, but you can't eat everything, so damn it. Daniel, you know the story. Somebody help me preach this thing so I can say, you know, Daniel, God told him you can't eat certain types of food. Yeah. Certain type of food will blow you up. You know how you can go around Pete's and McDonald's and Hardee's and places where I haven't seen a whole lot of you because I'm coming around too. You took my Hardee's. You know, you can eat that stuff will blow you up. So much sodium. You know, so much sodium heavy that was big, you know, and all out of shit. You see people come, you ain't got nothing coming in the Burger King, barely getting the Burger King. So God told Daniel. Ain't nobody mad at that. God told Daniel. He said, certain things you can't eat. Certain things will mess you up. You don't believe it. I was in the school system, and I watched some kids. I'm going to talk to the young people. I watched some kids got them French fries. I love me some potatoes. So. Got them French fries and they put ranch dressing on them French fries. And I kept on watching them. They got so bold they got two French fries. They got two things of that ranch dressing. And after a while they start blowing up. Amen. The wrong foods will mess us up. Amen. I'm serious about this thing. I watched them. Start gaining weight. You know how it is when you start gaining. Too much weight, I'm preaching to me. You start telling lies to yourself. Start telling lies to yourself. You tell yourself, as soon as I lose this weight, I'll be able to get back in them pants. I'm talking about men, you know. You're telling lies, knowing that we ain't gonna lose no weight. But church, when they brought down because God had told him not to eat certain food. So what they did, they brought down some of the king's food. All right. From the king's table. Amen. Daniel, y'all helping me? Daniel had a request. Amen. A resentment. If you would just read the scripture, he had a resentment. Amen. He had informed the priests and amen in the unison and the prince in the unison and that he should not defile himself. So Daniel, what he did, y'all know the story. Daniel asked the chief of the eunuchs to allow him not to defile himself. Why did he say that? That's the king coming from the king's table. Hold out of us. Amen. Because the king asked us to do something, we would have did it because the king brought us the food. But I come out here to serve notice on us the day that made a promise to God that we would serve him, we would obey him until we die. We need to line ourselves back up with what we told God, what we promised God that we would do. And somebody pray for me right now. I feel my help coming. But I need for you to pray for me. Amen. By eating meat from the king's table. And here's what the king had. Now, I don't know about you. I know some countries, amen, they serve horse meat. So what they had, they brought before. I don't know back then. Y'all help me. Some of you scholars, help me. Maybe that was a delicacy of horse meat. But I don't like it. I don't want it. And I don't like it. They had pork. I can't tell you I don't like pork. Y'all pray. Or wine. Or drinking wine. And the problem with the wine. The wine was sacrificed from the Babylonian gods to them. It was sacrificed to them. So that made the wine defiled. So here we got Daniel. Y'all praying with me? Check out, I don't know about you. Let me get my open confession here today. I don't know about you, but when it comes down to my relationship, I'm just talking about me. And I realize now I ain't no boy no more. That I'm a grown man. And I got my own mind. Anybody got your own mind? When it comes down to my relationship with God, it means more to me than anything in this world. Matter of fact, you know, you can lose a whole lot of stuff in life. But I come by to tell you, never lose your relationship. I know it's getting close to Valentine, and some of us can remember when we fell in love. Don't serve it to me.
Church Daniel, he was willing to risk his life. Amen. Because of his conviction with God, he rejected the food from the king's feast. We would call him crazy. That boy, young boy, he's crazy. Amen. Because the king don't play. Look at him. He's crazy now. Amen. Because the king would take his head. The king would kill him. But I heard, amen, that sometime, as I project to you, I heard that sometime we got to be a little crazy. Amen. Because the Bible says about the foolishness of preaching, men, amen, women, boys, and girls come to Jesus. I might look crazy right now, but I got plenty of sense. It's crazy, but he came out, king came up early in the morning, called a name, amen, and Daniel, amen. Matter of fact, he woke Daniel up. When God is with you, situations in your life, it might seem like you can't come out. God will help us rest on the stuff that we're going through. That's when you get your best sleep. When you're in the storm, that's when you realize that God is with you. You don't have a little bit.
He said, I fear my lord the king, who has appointed your meat and your drink. Get the word. He said, I fear. Because he appointed your meat and your drink. In other words, he was the one.
Yes.
He didn't ask you to order anything. He selected what he wanted you to have. So I fear him. I'm the chief, and I fear him. In other words, I'm the chef. I fear him. He gave it to me, and I give it to my cooks. He said, for why should he see your faces worse like than the children which are of your sort? Here's what he said. Then shall ye make me endanger my head to the king. In other words, here's what he said. He said, I don't know about you. I'm going to do what the king has said. Uh-huh. Here's why. Because if I don't, the king, I'm the chef, the king will cut my head off and put my head on a plate. Uh-huh. I come by to tell you, here's what the devil want to do. The devil want to take some of our heads off. Uh-huh. Are you trying, here's what he said, to kill me? Daniel, I like this. I like the intellectual. I like the power of God. When God calls somebody, he qualifies them.
Yes, he does.
And the anointing, the anointing comes, it comes afresh.
Yes.
And it teaches us things that we did not know.
Yes.
Let me share something with you. Here's what God is getting me to do in red here.
Uh-huh.
Get ready. Buckle yourself in.
Uh-huh.
Put your double strap on. You know,
yes.
How you strap the child in. Sometimes you have to put a strap down here, then you have to put a strap up here. If you don't put the strap in, get the law stop you. You're going to get a ticket anyhow because you did not properly strap the child in. So, children of God, strap yourself in.
Yes.
Because some great things is getting ready to happen in here. Y'all in here? Y'all in here? Y'all in here? I said some great things. I'm not saying this from my mind. I'm saying it from the anointing of God.
Yes.
That's why the church can't talk about nobody. Because
his intellectual ability. I'm not finished. Gave him strategies, and God gave him different techniques. So he conveyed, he talked to the sheriff. You know, you're talking to people, you gotta know how to talk language. You gotta know how to talk language so you can communicate. Amen. So he was talking to the sheriff. So, amen. So he began to cheat. He began to talk language to him. Jumped over to his world. Sometimes that's the only way you can reach people. You have to know something about them. Some of y'all don't know me. You think you know me, but you don't know me. Now, this ain't me all the time. I got a balanced life. Some folks are so unbalanced in the church. We ain't happy when we get here. That's why sometimes, and I call from that door, I said, come here. He said, come here, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, because I realize you can't get up here and preach something if you're out of compliance with God. Y'all look funny, but y'all look out. I can see that. I may not read, but I can see that. Some of y'all, I see your faces, you telling me that God that you don't like what pastor said, but I'm going to say it anyhow. I stand before God one of these days and give an account of everything I saw. Come on, Lord. Amen. So God gave that new strategy, new techniques to convey it to the sheriff. God called a captivity. So don't feel bad. Don't feel bad if you're still wrestling. Don't feel bad. Don't let nobody always going back pulling your past on you. Amen. God called a captivity person that was brought enslaved. That was called, amen, when he was nothing, but had all the capabilities in him because God had saved him and called him. Selected by a command of the king for a special supervision in mental, physical, and social discipline. Daniel had a cold conscience. And he would do anything, just everything. He had a cold conscience. Some things, amen, just convict him. Let me share. I'm not bragging about myself. But I, young boy, 19 years old, I went to St. Louis. Amen. I went there, drove, scared. People I was with went to sleep. Told me to read. I'll never forget that, the signs. Amen. I'm going around the mountain, scared to death. One over there, sleep. One back there, sleep. Telling me, ain't been nowhere. Maybe Greensboro, Charlotte, telling me, read the sign. Amen. Ain't that crazy? That was crazy to me. Amen. Mr. Town, Miss Town, we all wake up because I'm confused. I'm driving. Ain't never had a car round the mountains, cliffs over there, and y'all sleep. I'm like, y'all better get up here. Hey man, I'm getting dizzy up here. Going around all these mountains. What are you saying? I'm saying, hey man, I had a conscience. A cold conscience. But they said, keep reading the sign. Can we say Yeah, God told Daniel something deep down in his heart. And if you don't mind, let me share what I believe that God was telling him. God was telling Daniel, just like I'm telling the young people, that you are a brave hero. It does not matter where you come from. What matters where you're going. And I come by to speak a word into your life. That God is going to take you. But you have to make up in your mind when the sins of the world come at you. That you will not conform to the sins of the world. The food of the king's table. God had favor on him. And you know, you can't help it if God's got favor on you. The Lord blessed him. Now, I ain't gonna make no excuses if God has favor on me. God gave him a interpreting spirit where he was able to interpret dreams and visions. God gave Daniel, amen, an attitude and attention that reached emperors and kings. Amen. Daniel was blessed by God. God raised him up as a chancellor over back then the national university. Yeah, God just kept on blessing him and made him the governor over the province of Babylon. Where God allowed him to come into captivity. God put him high while he was in captivity. God made him the chief ruler over both Babylonia and Persian Empire. Daniel had some haters, but God continued to protect him and to preserve him. So let me tell the young people, folks ain't gonna like you. Folks gonna talk about you repeatedly. God put you down because you refuse to conform to the things of the world. Young people, because of Jesus, because he was and he is the one who died for you, and because of his resurrection power that has been transformed into your life, and because of Jesus saved you, and you know that you are saved because the Lord has blessed you. He made you a brave person. You ain't no coward and you ain't no wimp. You ain't scared or you ain't afraid. You just smart and you're spiritually correct because God is inside of you. I've got a confession. I wish some things that the Lord told me not to do when I was a young person. I wish I had listened to God. Amen. I feel like I would be far ahead than where I'm at now. But I come by to tell you, young people, there's a hero inside of you. Tell the devil when he tries to mess with you. Inside of them. Look what God did for Daniel. God raised Daniel up. Amen. And made Daniel a ruler because of his intellectual, his spiritual capability. Amen. All thing we need to do is just stay in the word. Stay on our knees and God will raise us up. God bless you. Help us smile upon you. Amen. God bless you. The doors of the church is open. Amen. My soul is happy.